This is my granddad's Bentley. I want one of these when I'm older.
That one's D&G and this one's Chanel. That's my Gucci one.
I don't have a bedroom at all. I have to sleep in my mum's bedroom, and then when they want to go to sleep, one of them will carry me into my bed.
Today in the UK, one in three children are living in poverty. And the gap between rich and poor has been growing.
UK.
No, not really.
We've just had a bailiff knock at the door and they're demanding £200 now.
Over a quarter of a million people sponsor children overseas. But what would happen if that scheme was applied to a family here?
We're in a position where we're probably fortunate enough to be able to do it.
We wanted to do this to give the kids a broader outlook on life, really, to give them an experience that most people don't get the chance to go through.
Over the next few months, the Mullins from Kent will be sponsoring the O'Dwyers from Brighton, a family they've never met.
I work full-time, but it's just not enough to support a family of four. It really isn't.
I was a bit shocked by that, to be honest with you. I was shocked that it worked.
When charity begins closer to home, some awkward realities will have to be confronted.
Sometimes at night we hear people having big rows and smashing glass bottles.
My brand and gone because it's not easy living here. I'll just go insane.
Wow. That's really nice.
It's so beautiful, I could cry.
But for two families who want more for their children, it's a partnership that will change their lives.
There's different ways of living, and I think I'm the lucky one.
I was asking my dad what poverty means because I've never heard of the word.
They're my golf clubs, which my dad's just bought me because I'm going to start golf soon.
This one's one of my favourite bags. It's a Louis Vuitton Paris.
10-year-old Daisy Mullins and her 13-year-old brother Ashley live with their parents in a gated community in Beckenham, Kent.
Where I live, it's like a mini town. It's surrounded by gates, it's got its own park.
Yeah, I feel really safe here because guards stay up all day and all night.
A person would dream of just living around here. In my wardrobe, I've got Ralph Lauren, Lacoste, Armani.
This is my laptop, and Ashley's got the exact same one.
I think that it's better to have design labels because if you're scruffy, it's like, it looks like you haven't got manners.
So the game is to get your family and the best house you can get?
Yeah.
What, and that's the game?
I get loads of money.
Dad Scott brings home a six-figure salary, working for his father's multi-million pound plumbing business.
My dad, you know, he was work, 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 work. And I never forget him saying to me, Scott, if you want good things in life, you will have to work.
And although the Mullins enjoy a five-star lifestyle with homes in the UK and Spain, Mum Sam has never taken their wealth for granted.
When Scott met me, I lived in a 15-storey block of flats in not a very nice area. Scott used to come in and bolt every door and... wasn't it?
Yeah.
For the next few months, the Mullins will be offering financial help to a family they've never met, who live 50 miles away on a council estate in Brighton.
The area where I live is very noisy at times. Some people who live here drink lots and they just go mad, and sometimes there's groups of teenagers that outside where I sleep.
9-year-old Brandon O'Dwyer and his brother Marcus live with their mum Michaela and stepdad Sean in one of the southeast most deprived neighbourhoods.
Right, here's the kitchen. Ages ago we came home and the washing machine had flooded everywhere and the door fell, so it's this. Right, here's the lounge where... and this is my bed where I sleep. It folds into a couch.
The O'Dwyers are fast outgrowing their two-bedroom council flat. As both boys are light sleepers, they can no longer share a room.
No, I don't have a bedroom at all. I have to sleep in my mum's bedroom and then they'll when they want to go to sleep, one of them will carry me into my bed and put me there.
I feel that at our age, we should be better off. We should have the comfortable home and the car and I look around and I see most people in their middle, late 40s are that way. I feel like somehow we're not quite what we should be.
We wanted to do this to give the kids a broader outlook on life, really, to enable them to have a better start than we had in our lives.
Stepdad Sean works shifts for the local bus company, bringing home a weekly wage of £280.
I work full-time, but it's just not enough to support a family of four. It really isn't.
Like the O'Dwyers, the majority of families living in poverty have one parent working in a low-paid job.
The money is there for us to survive, but we can't actually live. We can only survive. It's an endless source of worry and concern for me because I just feel I'm not providing for my family.
For the O'Dwyers, the reality of trying to live on a low wage means doing without.
Just walking, then I felt loads of water come in. I've only had them for a few months.
You need a new pair of shoes? What else can I say? I mean, I don't know how we're going to get them. Certainly not this week.
As well as needing to buy new shoes for Brandon, the O'Dwyers have fallen behind with their rent, and the situation has just become critical.
We are here to IRS test for removal of goods.
We've just had a bailiff knock at the door because the council tax is in my name. We got behind with it and we've been making payments as we can, as much as we can, but it's not enough for them and they've obviously sent a bailiff and they're demanding £200 now. You OK?
No, not really.
Was he here to take stuff?
Yes, but because we didn't let him in.
Imagine what that would have done to Marcus and Brandon. They would have been petrified.
Unaware of the crisis unfolding at the O'Dwyers, the Mullins are about to get their first glimpse of the family they are hoping to help.
Turn it up, Lairish.
Hello, I'm Brandon, and this is where I live. It's quite ugly to me, but... Marcus is my brother, and he's nearly four. Here's my bed right here. It can fold into a sofa. And there's my blanket right there. No, I don't have a bedroom at all. That's it. Okay, bye.
What do you think, guys?
Nice.
He's a nice boy, isn't he?
Yeah.
Wow. He's not got his own bedroom.
That's a bit sad, wasn't it?
Mm.
See if we can help him now, eh? He looked quite buzzy and lively, didn't he? So maybe we can help him a little bit, eh? Might do well in life still, mightn't he?
Mm-hmm. The kids need to learn. Need to learn about money and, you know, there is different people from them because at the moment they don't understand it.
Really quite upset, really, because me and Ash both have a room and he doesn't really have anything. He just has a sofa and it might not be very comfortable.
If I was living like there, I'd be scared. I would like it.